Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence asking forgiveness of my sins so that my prayer can enter your holy throne. Thank you, Father God, for the week that you have given us. Thank you for the start of school and many times work. Father, I thank you and I praise you for always providing for our each and every need. Help us, Lord, to rely on you as our ultimate provider. Help us to seek your face for everything that we need, spiritually, emotionally, physically, mentally, Lord. We thank you and we praise you because your promises are so true. Father, I cannot express how much gratitude I have that you are faithful to your promises. Father, thank you so much for those who are listening to the devotional, who are sharing the devotional, who are spending some time with you. May we grow spiritually, Lord, and may the seeds that we plant be nourished and grow so that our fruits can be seen. Father, these things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Without Christ, Nothing Makes Sense. It was written by Josue Andueza and translated by Ezequias Hernandez. Our biblical base comes from Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. So says the word of God. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. People who do not know Christ asked me about why we Christians pray for everything and continue reading the Bible even after we have read it several times. Others ask me about my addiction to the church stuff. It's like trying to explain what the sky is like to someone who has never seen it. Even so, it is necessary to make them understand that without Christ, nothing makes sense for us. Thus, we look for him frequently, like we are addicted to his presence. How could we not be if in his presence our hearts are filled with so much joy that it threatens to burst out of our chest? Many times with the questions, there are genuine opportunities to speak of the Lord. I know that many try to diminish our faith with their questions, but we have to remember that their questioning is a manifestation of the emptiness they have in their lives for not having Christ. Nothing is impossible for God, so let us take advantage of every opportunity to sow, and let us wait for him to do his work changing and restoring a life with his touch as he once did with ours. Amen. My brothers and sisters, anytime somebody asks us questions about our faith, about why we do the things that we do for church, why we cover our head, or why we dress in a certain way, always take those questions as an opportunity to share our faith. We never know if our answer to a question is going to be what God is going to use to bring them to a saving knowledge of himself. So my brothers and sisters, don't get frustrated with questions from unbelievers. Don't get exasperated with them for asking questions over and over and over, because God can use anything. Any phrase that sparks the person's interest or makes them look or perceive something a little differently, God can use it. So be ready to answer questions about our faith. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory. Amen. What a beautiful song. And now we invite you to check out our YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry, for our daily Bible reading. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.